My name is Philip Prescott. I do custom fabrication.
So we're a grand format printer, and we also do event fabrication.
My name is Jeremy Carlson. I run Avant-Garde Design down here in Palm City, Florida.
Yeah, so I'm Jeremy Katz from JK Automotive Designs. We build custom interiors for vehicles from scratch.
So right now we prototype the face shield, and we are in full-blown production with this at this point. This is it here. So we have clear PETG, has a pre-masked front and back, and the polystyrene is a separate piece, and what holds it together is the elastic, so it cinches both pieces together.
And they said, can you make intubation boxes? Because they have none. And I asked for a diagram, and they sent it to me. We designed one, and we added interlocking corners and edges on it, so when the box folds up, it just interlocks together.
These are the ones that we're making. It basically has a 3D printed chin piece at the bottom. This clear section is another, it's just detachable. So you can pop these off pretty easily.
The laser allows us to cut teeth into the shields. And you can actually pull this and then it holds it tight, it won't come loose.
You know, with the Trotec, it allowed me to prototype a lot of different options.
They're fairly easy to manufacture, but places like New York and DC, Florida, Chicago, are having a lot of trouble keeping those in stock because it used to be the case that you use one and you throw it away. And then it got to the point where, you know, you'd have one per day and then you'd have one per week. And now, you know, we're getting reports that some hospitals, they have one per department and they have to share. And some hospitals have nothing except trash bags.
The one the state's making up in Massachusetts where Jeremy is, they're disposable. You put them on, you take them off and throw them away. Every patient you see. These, you can use a UV light on. The foam's UV stable, the plastic's UV stable, and so is the elastic. And so you can take a UV light to it and disinfect it, or you can spray it down with disinfectant and clean them and go see the next patient right away.
You know, I'm not gonna, you know, basically sit here and wait. Let's try to figure out something we could do to help with COVID-19. Also, to get my guys back in here and keep them employed, and we didn't have to worry about putting them on employment.
By doing the mask, it made us essential. And so I was able to keep my business open. So I was able to keep paying my employees and bringing them to work. Not only were we helping the communities, but we were able to stay at work for my employees and their families as well.
When we developed this and you know, I looked at it, I said, is this something, if my son or daughter was working as a first responder, you know, is this something I'd feel comfortable with them wearing? And 100% it is.
It's really scary to think, you know, your friends and family could be the people out there. So making something that can help as many people as possible, that's really easy for me while I'm stuck at home and I have this, you know, giant machine in my garage and just pump these out, you know, it's a no-brainer. It's like, you got to, you know, you can't not do that. Otherwise, you know, you could be, you know, helping a lot of people.
We literally got the laser cutter, I think, 4 weeks ago. And for 2 weeks, this thing has been running like nonstop around the clock.
On a good day, I can do a few thousand.
And I'm guessing our group, we've probably done 25 or 30,000 masks or shields in the last 2 weeks.
We've managed to make nationwide, probably by now, I would say at least 40, 50,000.
So we got the, you know, we got the laser cutter just to start doing the pin mount letters. And literally I had it, I did two jobs on it. And I go, oh my God, you know, the work's gone. So after that, then we started making these face shields and the thing, I don't know how many hours we put on it, you know, 10 hours times the 2 weeks. We had weekends and everything else on it. And it hasn't failed us once, not a problem, no issues with it. It just runs nonstop.
So I can cut tons of stuff really quickly. I mean, that's just the great part about the laser in general. You know, Trotecs are just, they're workhorses, they don't stop, they're effective. They're big and they're fast.
You know, this was a no-brainer, having the Trotec there and being able to put this prototype together. And it's awesome. The entire maker community, and it could be a trophy shop, it could be a guy that's doing letters, somebody with a CNC router.
We shared the file with the entire industry online, including the car audio electronics industry and the upholstery industry, and pretty much anything automotive related that does fabrication or builds cars or any of that. And we wrote, the headline was "Attention Shops with a Laser Machine. Here's a file that you can use to help make PPE for hospitals locally."
So what I did, is I made the template for the face shield, I made open source. I put it on forums, I put it wherever I could. Anybody that was willing to listen, the information was in front of them. And I had a lot of requests, so I've been sending this template out. And it's been going literally like across the world.
The group that we're in is about, 1,500 or 1,600 strong right now. And so most of those are 3D printing people.
Trying to form like an alliance between all the shops as opposed to having competitors and trying to keep secrets. This is something, it almost reminds me of, like documentaries you see about World War II where Maytag, they used to make washing machines for clothes, then they converted over and are making parts for airplanes. So it's almost like we have to retool, and to do that, the information has to be there. So, Trotec makes it so easy to share information. Hey, these are the settings, plug them in there. Buy this film and, go to it and just, start being a hero.
Jeremy's shop and my shop and everybody else around the country for sure has the skill sets, and most of them have the tooling to make a little difference until somebody like Apple and Nike and Ford and whoever else is doing it, that till they can step up and get it into the hospitals at large amounts.
Is, hey, run downstairs and let's try to see if we can figure this out, has turned into a phenomenon, we're not doing a million masks like Apple is, or we're not doing 200 million masks like Nike is, but we're doing our part for sure. We feel that we've stepped up and done our part. We're the fire extinguisher until the fire truck shows up.
Our website is jkautomotivedesigns.com.
You can check us on Facebook and Instagram, and then our website is avant-garddesign.com.
I share the template. If anybody needs a template, you can email me at rocco@vinylbomb.com.
3dforcovid.com is our website. If you need PPE gear, if you're a hospital that needs it, there's a form there that you can fill out. If you make, there's a, I can make stuff button, and there's also a donate button.